course I am, you silly bugger. Get the whiskey.
What's wrong, lady?
Hello, Doreen. When'd you get out? You remember Doreen Anderson, don't you, Phil? She and a mate of his gave the department the runaround for 3 weeks.
Yeah, I remember. Doyle shot my mate. How come they let you out so soon?
I got paroled.
Where are you living now?
The halfway house.
That'd go easy in the stuff if I were you. Could get you in trouble, you know.
Oh, I've been celebrating with my fiance. I better get going. He's probably waiting for me.
Anyone we know?
Oh, no. He's never had nothing to do with you blokes.
Glad to hear it.
Here, take a deep breath. Easy now.
You got any brandy?
Here, let me take this.
Get your paws off me. I mean, I'll get my second wind in a minute, and I'll be out of here in a tick.
Don't move. I'll get help.
Oh, God.
Can you two fellas give us a hand? I've got a woman inside who's... Well, just a minute. Did you pay for those?
I forgot I had them. I was going to pay for them honest, but when that little old lady took a turn inside, I came out here for help.
What little old lady? You didn't mention anything about a little old lady before.
Yeah, well, you scared me. And I'm not used to going to the cops for help.
Look, I don't want anyone dying in my shop.
Leave her alone! Doreen never did nothing. It's me you ought to be taken in. I made her do it. Oh, Lizzie.
I knew it. The minute you two walked in, they've robbed me. The oldest trick in the book, and I fell for it.
That proves it was my idea. She's too young to know.
Come on, both of you. We'll sort this out down at the station, OK?
I'll take those. And we'll need your statement.
My pleasure.
You rotten mongrel! Too mean to give an old lady a drop of brandy!
There you are.
They won't be too hard on us, Dor. It's only two lousy bottles. You stick to your story and leave the rest to me.
No talking.
They sobered up yet?
I think so, sir.
Now, let's see if we can get this story straight. And I warn you both again that anything that you say might be used in evidence.
I told you I was going to pay for them.
A constable?
Yes, sir.
Were both these ladies searched when they were brought in?
Yes, sir.
And did either of them have any money on them?
Well, Mrs. Birdsworth had 40 cents in her purse.
We must have been robbed. Where was you
it's
lot when
you... It's not going to work.
Oh, fair go. Dor never had nothing to do with it. She couldn't talk her way out of a paper bag.
Yeah, well, regardless of whose idea it was, the owners are only pressing charges against Anderson. However, after hearing what the arresting officers had to say, and from what you've been telling us, Mrs. Birdsworth, we've got no alternative but to charge you both with theft.
But I was boozed. I never knew what I was saying. And Dor must have thought I had some money. Yeah, that's right. You thought I was going to pay, didn't you, Dor?
Yeah, well, you can save that one for the magistrate and see if he'll believe you. You're both to appear in court on the morning of the 11th, and your bail has been set at 40 cents, Mrs. Birdsworth.
Oh, can't you fix it for Dor, 20 cents each way?
It's not that simple. Now, the first condition on your parole is don't break the law. Bail cannot be set. You'll be remanded in Wentworth Detention Centre.
Lights out in half an hour.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher, how long will Judy be in solitary?
Well, that's up to the governor or the VJ. But I'll see to it that she's moved from this cell, if that'll make you happier.
I don't want her moved.
You saw how violent she can be.
Well, she's not going to bother me. At least she's honest about her feelings.
So what is it with you? Every time I try to help you, you treat me as though I'm poison.
I'm grateful you helped my mother, but I just wish you'd leave me alone.
Listen, I happen to believe in you. And I don't think you belong here. Now, is that a crime? Is it to want you out of this place?
If I didn't accept bail from Michael, I'm certainly not going to accept it from you.
I don't expect you to be indebted to me, Simpson. I'll leave that sort of emotional blackmail to your husband.
Then why are you so interested in what happens to me?
I told you why.
I don't believe you.
Well, maybe, just maybe. I had this vague notion that I'd like to get to know you better. Outside. But people are human beings, not animals. Good night, Mr. Simpson.
Well, it was the only way I could be near you. I mean, I don't know how long I'm going to be in here, but if you like, I'm sure I can arrange to have the same time, huh? Sharon, I know how lonely you get on your own, and I thought at least we could talk, right? Sharon? Sharon!
Yeah, I'm listening.
Well, aren't you going to say something?
What do you want me to say? Gee, thanks, Jude. Thanks for getting yourself thrown in the pound just for me. Well, you can take a flying jump for all I care. I've got a week in here because of you and another hanging over my head. So if you want me to talk to you, you could just go to hell.
Look, I didn't set you up, Sharon. Pat O'Connell did.
Bull.
No, it's true. I mean, Bea would have put her up to it. I'm telling you, I saw her plant them. I mean, why would I lie to you? Heck, I could have hit anybody to get in here, but I chose Bea to get back at her for what she did to you.
You bitch! You rotten, bloody bitch! Why didn't you tell the screws that?
I had to separate you and Chrissie. It was the only way. I did it because I love you.
You wait. I'll get you for this. I hate you, you big, stupid cow. I hate you! Thanks for all you've done, Tony. I couldn't have gone through all that by myself.
Any time, you know that.
I think Mum and Dad will write me off after this. If you hadn't have been there...
They'll be all right. They didn't seem to think much of Bill, though, did they? I mean, not just because he got you into trouble.
No, well, they think he led me astray when we got busted with the drugs.
Well, I was in it too.
Yeah, but we weren't living together.
Say,
hey.
Sorry, I'm late. I had a bit of an emergency.
Oh, that's all right. Do you want a drink?
Yeah, why not? Why not?
Would it be all right if Sally stayed a couple of days extra? It's, well, just that, you know, her parents weren't too keen on her being pregnant, and, she doesn't want to go back to
I was wondering what this drink business was all about. You don't have to get me sloshed to say yes, you know.
And she can stay?
You're the one sleeping on the couch, mate.
Thanks, Tat. Her family doctor made the appointment at the clinic, and she's having the operation tomorrow. She just needs a bit of support, that's all.
Yes, yes.
No worries.
Thanks, Mr. Reed. Well, I best get to bed. Good night and
Thanks again.
Night, sir. So, what was this emergency about?
Oh, do you really want to hear about it?
Oh, why not? You're always interested in what I'm doing.
Fair enough. It was an attempted suicide. One of the women, out on bail. Just a minute. Have you done your assignments?
Of course I have. Well, Sally did stand over me a bit.
If I tried that, I'd be in a fight in a minute. Maybe she should move in here permanently. Joke.
Mrs. Barry's late coming in, isn't she?
I'll stay until she arrives. There are a few reports that need doing. In fact, I've been thinking of doing one on staff and inmate relationships.
And what exactly do you think that'll achieve?
It might prove to the department that men shouldn't be working in a female prison.
If and when you get the proof, Miss Bennett, I'll hand the deputy governorship over to you personally.
Excuse me. Got another guest for you.
Well, come on, we haven't got all night.
I'll take the charge sheet.
I'll take it. You know the procedure, Anderson. Well, you lasted longer than I expected. I knew you'd manage to find your way back here somehow.
What happened, Doreen?
I only took 2 bottles of grog.
You address all officers by name. Surely you haven't forgotten that.
No, Miss Bennett.
I'll be able to handle this, thank you, Mr. Fletcher.
Just see she's put in a cell with someone she knows.
Yes, I know where we can put you. In with someone who'll be really pleased to see you back.
I don't mind being on my own, Miss Bennett. I don't want to wake anyone up.
You better get used to being in a dormitory, Anderson. That little escapade mightn't have seemed much to you, but you broke parole. I'd say there's every chance that you'll be serving the rest of your sentence. Thought you might like to meet your new cellmate, Smith.
Doreen! What the bloody hell are you doing here?
You've got 10 minutes to settle in, Anderson. I'm sure it won't take you that long to tell them why you broke parole.
For God's sake, you silly little idiot. What have you gone and done?
I'll give her a chance, B.
I'll give her exactly 1 minute before I thump the living daylights out of her.
Oh, everything was going okay and we were celebrating and the cops didn't know what we'd done and they were going to let me go, but Lizzie thought they were arresting me and they weren't. Anyway, she came and put her foot right in it. And everything was really good. Then it all went wrong.
I'm just a good-for-nothing, stupid old cow, and I ought to be locked up in a hole in the ground. She was doing all right till I came along. Do you reckon they'll lock me up?
After serving so much time for something you didn't do?
No, they'll probably just fine you, that's all. Well, what do you reckon they'll do to Dore?
Well, she broke parole.
Yeah. I'll never be able to live with myself if they put her away for something that I did. I've buggered up her life. And all because I can't lay off the grog for more than 2 minutes. Well, that does it. I'm not going to touch another drop. Never, ever. Never. And I can rot in hell if I go back on my word. What am I going to tell Kev?
Look, you go to court the day after tomorrow. They mightn't do anything to her.
Yeah. And he doesn't have to find out if she gets off. And I'm gonna see to it that she does get off.
How are you going to do that?
I don't know. But I'll do something. You just wait.
Don't do this to me, Sharon. You know I can't stand it when you go silent on me. How many times do I have to say I'm sorry? You just can't throw away 3 years together and pretend they never happened. I mean, don't you care? How can you love somebody, spend all that time together, and just pretend nothing's ever happened? Sharon, I know that the only reason that you turned to Chrissie was because you needed someone to look after you. You know, make a fuss over you. Well, I always did that, didn't I? to me. Sharon! It's my trial today, damn you! I can't go and face that knowing I have nothing to come back to. I committed a crime to get in prison for you. It's all been for you. It's always been for you. Don't you care?
Stop that,
Sharon, Bryant. Oh, God. I want to see the governor.
What about?
Something the narcotics squad should be very interested in.
I'll let her know. Come on, O'Connell.
I heard you're the one who set me up. You were getting too smart for your own good. When I get out of here, I'd watch it if I could. And that goes for B. Smith, too.
Look, I've been inside too long for a little girl like you to scare me. Now, be a good girl and eat your breakfast.
O'Connell?
Coming, Mr. Fletcher.
Hello, Dad. Look, I won't keep you long, but, look, I don't want Sally to go to the clinic by herself today, so can I borrow the car?
Well, isn't there somebody else who can take her, a girlfriend or something? Well, listen, Tony, she's not entirely your responsibility, mate. Come in.
You wanted to see me?
Oh, yes. Tony, yeah, that'll be okay. I'll leave the keys for you at the front gate.
Thanks, Dad.
You sure he didn't mind?
No way. You know, it's funny, but ever since you came here, he and I have been getting on much better. Hello? 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 Is there anybody? I thought heavy breathers only rang women. Must be women's lib or something.
Well, she seemed okay when I saw her last. But in my opinion, she should have somebody with her all the time. It's not too late to organize Bell, you know that.
No.
I can't understand why you're being so adamant about this. It can't be all pride.
I know it's Mr. Fletcher's money. I don't want to be indebted to him.
Well, I'm sure that's the last thing he would want. He was hoping that you wouldn't find out where the money was coming from. That's why I agreed to go surety on his behalf. All right, I'll talk to Mrs. Davidson, see if we can't arrange for you to visit your mother. You're absolutely sure that you won't...
Thank you, but I'm quite sure.
I'm sorry to hear about your mother.
Why don't you tell me it was my fault?
Pardon?
Well, if I'd let you pay my bail, I would have been with her. None of this would have happened, right?
Look, let's just forget about it, okay?
Mr. Fletcher, it's just that I don't know who to trust anymore.
Well, isn't it about time you took a gamble and found out?
Don't let me interrupt you, Mr. Fletcher.
You weren't interrupting anything, Miss Bennett.
What's he been saying to you?
What do you mean?
Inmates do have rights, you know. If Mr. Fletcher's been trying to take advantage of you, then the governor should be told.
No, he hasn't.
On the other hand, if you think you'll be getting it easier in here by getting friendly with a male officer, you'd better think again. If you're caught, it can go just as badly on the inmate as it can the officer.
That's a disgusting thing to say.
I'll be keeping my eye on you. Just remember that.
Well, didn't you think you might get caught? You knew the conditions of your parole. You had some money from your mother's will, a nice bloke to marry you, and you went and blew the lot.
Bee. Look, Sharon's got something to tell the narcotics people. You think it could be about me planting those pills on her?
Oh, no way. Look, if she wanted to lag, she'd just tell the governor. It must be something else.
Oh, she's going to be trouble when she gets out of the pound.
Yeah, well, it's Bryant I'm interested in.
Well, she only bashed you so she could get near Sharon.
Yeah, well, if she wants to play games, I've got a few I could teach her.
O'Connell, aren't you supposed to be working in the kitchen?
Well, yes, Miss Bennett. I just brought some clean clothes for Doreen.
Oh, Miss Bennett, I've read your report on Bryant. Her trial's this afternoon, so I think we'd better keep her in solitary until then. At least she'll be out of Smith's way.
She won't try anything without her lackeys. And apart from O'Connell and now Anderson,
She doesn't have anyone else?
Oh, yes, I heard Doreen was back. Where is she now?
In the showers.
Well, bring her to my office when she's finished, please, Miss Bennett. I have seen you do a lot of foolish things in the past, Doreen. But this, it was not only foolish, it was absolutely thoughtless. When I recommended your parole, it was because I believed in you. You had your mother's support, all the help you could possibly need from the halfway house. Everyone was assisting you. Do you want to contact anyone? What about your fiancé?
Oh, no. Kevin mustn't find out what I've done.
Well, he's bound to find out sooner or later.
He can't, because his mother will break us up if he doesn't wipe me first. Anyhow, I might get off tomorrow. Lizzie will tell him what happened, and they've got to believe that I never meant to break my parole. I'll swear I'll never do it again. And then I can just tell Kevin that I've been visiting friends for a couple of days. Everything will be all right, won't it? Oh, Miss Bennett reckons I've got to come back and do the 6 months that owe to me. But I never meant to let anyone down. Not Kevin or you. I was trying, I promise. Oh, just no good.
What are we going to do with you, Doreen?
G'day.
What do you want?
I want to talk to you about Dor.
About what?
That poor little kid that you just had put back inside.
Poor little...
And if you don't tell the cops that you made a mistake...
Get out of my shop.
You want to know something? I just got out after serving 20 years for murder. And I met a lot of toughies in there. Most of them are out now. So if you don't do like I said...
If you're not out of here within 2 seconds, I'm calling the police. This time, they might put you back where you belong.
Yeah, they might. But I better make sure.
Hey, what are you doing? Stop it, you're out of your mind.
Yeah.
Hello, police.
Bloody rotten
look,
gun.
Get over here,
only brings you trouble. Of all the rotten, lousy luck. How they expect anyone to learn a lesson when they let people off the hook?
Come on, Mrs. Birdsworth, you should be grateful.
Snivelling little coward. All he was worried about is getting paid for his lousy plonk. For two bob
I... Stay away from him. You've got one charge against you.
Hey, if I didn't pay for them bottles, they'd have to lock me up, wouldn't they?
Look, getting arrested isn't going to help your friend. Could even have an effect on her trial.
How's that?
Well, they mightn't be too happy, knowing that she was keeping company with a dangerous element.
Enough to drive you to drink, isn't it?
After I've seen Bryant, I would like to do an inspection of H Block. I think it's time we opened the security gates between wings.
I admit it's been a bit more peaceful, but that's because of tighter security. If we slacken off now, it'd be asking for trouble.
We shall see. Yes. Two gentlemen from the narcotics branch are here, Bryant. They want to ask you a few questions before your trial.
What about?
I think it's fair to warn you that Gilmour is making a statement now. After what she told me, I thought it necessary to call them in. She claims that she was not telling the whole truth at her trial, that you were the one behind trafficking in drugs, and that you forced her to deliver them.
And you believed her? It's not true. I mean, I never had anything to do with it.
I am merely explaining what has been said.
Well, it's not true. I mean, she's a born liar.
That's enough of that, Bryant.
Look, she even tried to involve that other fella, you know, Reed, Tony Reed.
She said she did that because she was covering for you.
Well, it's not true.
Well, you admitted to smuggling drugs into the prison.
Yeah, well, at the time, I wanted to get in here. I mean, when Sharon was sentenced, I had to do something to be near her.
Yes. I'll send her straight away. They're ready for you.
The longer I work here, the less I understand about human nature.
That's because they're sick. We're not dealing with normal people.
Heard you got engaged?
Yeah.
What's your fella like then?
Oh, he's nice. Real nice.
That the ring?
Yeah, so what?
All right, don't get your nappy in a knot. I just want to have a look at it. You have to get married or something?
No.
Oh, you're holding out on him, are you?
Well, you're just jealous because you never got engaged.
Oh, well, I didn't have to, did I? I mean, I could get any bloke I wanted. I didn't have to marry him.
Give it back, Chrissie.
Cool. It looks like you've got yourself a real big spender here, doll.
Come on.
Oh, it must be glass at least. Mm. Or is it plastic?
You little bitch.
Or maybe you brought it yourself.
Give it to me.
I'll take that. Up to your old tricks again, are you, Latham? Well, maybe you should try me on for size.
You don't measure up no more. Big Mouth Smith, clobbered by a newcomer. You've lost your sting.
We'll see about that.
What was that the Gov said? You get into strife and you'll end up in isolation, wasn't it? Well, it nearly finished you the last time. I don't reckon you could take another stint in there.
It's going to be worth it for you.
Oh, me!
Now, you were saying?
Don't you ever learn?
She clobbered me for no reason, Mrs. Davidson.
That's not true.
Shut up, Doreen.
Oh, no, I'm sick of being told what to do. She pinched my ring, Mrs. Davidson, and B was only trying to get it back.
Bloody lagger!
Quiet, Latham.
Very well. Miss Bennett, I'm sure you can find something for Smith and Latham to do to cool them down.
With pleasure. Outside.
Mrs. Davidson, when can I visit the baby?
From what I've seen, you're not exactly showing you deserve any privileges.
Please, Mrs. Davidson. Well, you let Caroline Simpson out to visit her mother in hospital. I'm going mad cooped up in here.
Very well. See the duty officer.
Thanks.
You know, you really shouldn't have that ring, Doreen.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, I've got to keep it. Please.
All right. But be very careful.
Yeah?
Hi, it's me, Lizzie. It's Kevin.
Oh, just a minute. Oh, g'day, Kev.
Oh, hi. I just thought I'd come around and see Doreen. I'm going to take her out to lunch.
You just missed her.
Oh.
She's gone shopping for a wedding.
Oh, we'll tell her I'll see her tonight then. We'll go to a movie or something.
Oh, you can't do that. We're giving her a party. No, no fellas allowed.
Well, that should make a switch.
Eh?
Oh, nothing. I just thought she might have told me, that's all.
Oh, well, you see, we're springing it, aren't we? And I've got a lot to do, and so...
Yeah, OK, I'm going. But tell her I'll see her tomorrow, OK? If she can spare the time.
Yeah.
OK. I've got the car. You ready? Oh, hi, Bill.
G'day. I heard Sally could have been here. It was just a matter of ringing till she answered the phone to be sure.
So it was you on the phone this morning?
The kid's got brains.
Yeah, what do you want?
Her back with me where she belongs. Without the kid, of course. But she said she's taken care of that.
She doesn't want anything more to do with you, mate.
Where do you fit into the picture, mate? You're too young for a girl like Sally. You're just doing the Good Samaritan bit, eh? Like father, like son.
Just get out of here.
What if I don't? You gonna try kicking me out?
Oh, no, Bill, no trouble, please.
Seeing as how you are so nicely. So long, Sal. You too, kid.
I could have handled it.
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
You wouldn't have gone back to him, would you, Sal?
Look, I just want to get this whole thing over and done with.
Oh, I'm sorry. It can't be as bad as all that. I mean, they said you'd be out in 2 or 3 hours. You know, I'd do anything for you, don't you, Sal?
Oh, Tony.
Come on. We better get going.
Now, B, shouldn't you have some of the others doing that?
No, the old vinegar's keeping tabs on me.
Well, do you want a hand? Because after all, it was my fault you got into trouble.
Oh, me and Chrissie were headed for a scrap anyhow.
That Judy's real tough, eh?
I just need 1 minute alone with her.
And did she really lay into you right in front of everyone? You've been having it real tough since Lizzie and me got out, haven't you, B?
It just takes a while to break in the new recruits, that's all.
Yeah, but we know you're still the boss.
Now, God knows why, but I missed you and that old devil, Lizzie. Not that I'm glad to see you back in here. I don't know why I wasted my breath talking to you two.
You're supposed to be doing that, Smith.
Ah, yeah, well, it's a smoker, Mr. Jackson. Union regulations?
I can give you some more regulations if you like. Lizzie's here to see you, Doreen.
Well, we'll tell her I'm sick or something.
That's no way to treat Lizzie.
Yeah, I know, but if she'd just kept her silly mouth shut...
Oh, come on, it wasn't all Lizzie's fault.
She ain't tried to save you.
She's brought some things in for you. You want me to tell her to take them back?
Can't say I'd blame her if she wouldn't want nothing to do with me. You always said I was stupid, Miss Bennett, and you was right. I should never have been allowed outside. Rotten to the bone.
Will you go and sit over there, Birdsworth?
It's like old times, you telling me what to do, Miss Bennett. Gets a bit hard thinking for yourself after such a long time inside. And when I do, I bugger it up. I've taken the pledge, you know, Miss Bennett. We should get together sometimes and have a yarn about the good old days.
Will you be quiet?
Oh, Miss Bennett, you wouldn't.
Oh, don't be stupid, Birdsworth.
Come on, Lizzie.
You mean she'll see me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. I always said you was all right, Miss Bennett. Good day, Dor.
Hello, Lizzie.
You mean you're not crook on me?
Oh, no, I reckon it's about time I faced up to my own mistakes.
I brung some of your stuff in. I tried to talk some sense into that coot down the bottle shop, but he wouldn't listen. Kevin came round. I covered up for you. He's coming around tomorrow. I don't know how long I can stall him off.
Well, he's got to know the truth, Lizzie.
What?
He's got to. I owe him that much. And you can tell him that if he doesn't want to see me, that I'll understand and that I'm sorry and that I... You know.
But she's got to get off, isn't she, Mrs. Jackson?
I don't know.
But she's got to get off. Dawn never did nothing. Oh, God, Dawn, what are we going to do?
Now, Lizzie, if you'd go over and sign the visitor's book, and Doreen, you sign the property book, please.
I'm going to make a fortune on the Gigi's. I didn't get a chance to back Whiskey a Go-Go today. I'd go and see that rotten mongrel in the bottle shop. I'll bet the bloody thing wins, too.
I'm not going till I see Sharon Gilmour.
You will do as you're told.
I have to see her before I go. I can't go now.
You can
like
talk
this.
To her after the trial.
Now, look, if you're going to behave like that, the court will get up
dead, don't you?
Where are you going, Lizzie?
Shh. She's more worried about Gilmour turning against her than her trial.
Well, she went to all that trouble to be with her.
Serves her right.
All right, come on, Doreen.
Just a minute. Did you see Birdsworth leave the building?
No, why? She wouldn't.
I wouldn't be surprised at anything she does. All right, Anderson. What's she up to?
Oh, I don't know, Miss Bennett. I've never seen a thing.
Officer Knox, take Anderson back to her cell.
With the security gate closed, she can't have gone far.
She could be hiding anywhere. She could find a way around here blindfold.
Well, it seems to me that there are more women trying to get into Wentworth than out.
Yes, Miss Bennett?
We've been looking for Birdsworth everywhere.
I was told you knew where she was.
Oh, must have slipped me mind. I could have...
Come on, Birdsworth. This time I'll make sure that at least you reach the gates.
We haven't quite finished yet, thank you, Miss Bennett.
It was nice of you to worry about me, Miss Bennett.
That'll be the day.
Oh, come on, Mrs. Davidson. Your father was a judge. He must have taught you a few lurks.
Not that I can remember, Lizzie.
If Dor gets put away again and I'm not... I don't want to be out there on my own.
Oh, don't talk nonsense.
I've been here since this place was built. I know every brick. You're the boss, Mrs. Davidson. I wouldn't take up much room.
Well, you've settled into the halfway house now, Lizzie.
Yeah, but I can't stay there forever, you know.
Haven't you made other plans?
I was going to move in with Dora and Kev after they were married.
Well, you'll have some money soon. You could buy a place of your own.
What good's a house of my own? I could be dead for months and no one would miss me. It's hard to make friends at my age, Mrs. Davidson. All my friends are in here.
Well, maybe we're being a little premature. Doreen hasn't been sentenced yet.
I don't know what's going to happen when Kev finds out. He'll probably wipe us both. Dor needs him, Mrs. Davidson. He's the first decent fella that's ever been any good to her.
You all right? Do you want to go for a drink or something somewhere?
I wouldn't mind.
Look at him, falling over himself. How wet can you get?
Whatever happens tomorrow, don't try to elaborate. Just tell the truth and I'm sure the magistrate will be fair.
Yeah, all right, Lizzie, what's going on?
Oh, what do you mean, creeping up on me like that? In my day, when things got tough, a young fella could take it. You can't just up and dump her when she hasn't done nothing, Kevin.
For crying out loud, what are you going on about?
It was my doing. She hasn't done anything that you could blame her for.
Lizzie!
She's been arrested, Kev.
What?
Excuse me, you must be Kevin.
Yeah.
I'm Erica Davidson. The governor of Wentworth Detention Center.
So Doreen is back inside?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Yeah, and if a lady like Mrs. Davidson can stick by a door when things get a bit shaky, I don't see why you can't.
I think we should go inside and discuss this calmly, Lizzie.
Yeah, well, just what I was about to say, Mrs. Davidson.
Excuse me, are you really the governor of a jail?
Yes, and a friend of Lizzie and Doreen's.
Yeah, but what if she does have to go back?
Well, 6 months isn't a lifetime.
Of course it isn't. Now, if you had to wait for me for 20 years, that'd be different.
I know it isn't easy on family and friends, but believe me, it's far worse for the women inside. I've seen too many of them rejected.
Yeah, she only got carried away because she was so happy she was marrying you.
Doreen has been institutionalized most of her adult life. She thought that was the only thing she could expect. But you've given her something else, Kevin. A future.
Yeah, well, I should have my own business going in about 6 months, so... need more money in the bank. Better start for us both.
I knew you'd come good.
Thanks, Lizzie.
And I'm gonna move right away from her. Dora and myself could never keep out of trouble when we were together. I'm gonna get right out of your hair.
Yeah, you bet you will. Because I'm gonna keep an eye on both of you. We're not gonna let you out of our sight, all right?
Well, I'd better be going. Goodbye, Lizzie.
Could I get a lift with you, please, Mrs. Davidson? I want to see Doreen.
Yes, of course.
See you, Lizzie.
Sure you're old enough to be drinking?
Just ignore him, Tony.
Why don't you join us, Sally? We can go over old times.
Will you leave us alone?
Oh, so it's us now, is it? You decided to like him younger these days, Sal.
Why don't you shut up?
The kid can speak for himself. What do you know?
Tony, let's go. He's not worth it.
That's right, little boy. Do what Mummy tells you to do.
Tony, no!
Come on, have a go. Have a go. What's the matter, Goldilocks? What's stopping you? Not as tough as you thought, eh?
Tony, let's go, please.
Yeah, yeah, run along, Junior, before you get yourself hurt.
Come on, let's get out of here.
You've had it, mate. I'll get you.
Tony!
Judith Frances Bryant, you've been sentenced to 1 year imprisonment, having been found guilty of trafficking in drugs. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yeah, I'm guilty.
You better learn a few manners, Bryant. You wanted to be here, so you'll learn to play the game our way. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Now, I want you to go behind the screen and change into these.
You'll be sorry to hear that Sharon's evidence didn't hold up in court. They only got on me what I wanted them to get.
Then you're a fool. Or hadn't you noticed that your little friend doesn't care what happens to you?
You don't know anything about that.
She made that statement to get out of another week in solitary. That's not much in exchange for a very close friendship, is it?
It wasn't necessary, Vera.
This is a prison, and not a hearts and flowers club.
Well, I reckon that's about the first time I've ever seen Lizzie stuck for words.
Mrs. Jackson, would you tell Doreen that Kevin Burns is here to see
her? Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
I'll take you to the interview room.
Thanks.
Miss Bennett, I finished the laundry.
We'll take that back to the storeroom.
Yeah, but I can't get through the security gate. Can you let me through, please?
You've got 2.5 minutes, Bryant.
Now, if you see Sharon, you tell her she's welcome to you.
Oh, ta very much.
Well, good day.
Oh, no, you don't. There's one thing you can learn about me, Bryant. I don't like being hit in the face when I'm not looking. Now, this may not be a public affair, but there never was one for exhibition. Oh, no! Just get away from me. Do you understand? Good.
You should have finished this ages ago, Smith.
Well, if a job's worth doing properly.
How did this happen to you, Bryant?
It's an accident.
Leaky pipes.
All I know is I want to be with you, you know? Look, I don't care if it takes 6 months or a week. I'm going to be waiting for you, Doreen.
Well, what are you going to tell your mum?
Oh, I can take care of her. I'll just tell her that... Well, no, bugger, I'll tell her the truth. You know, it's our life, not hers. She can like it or lump it. I'm not going to let you down, you know?
I'm not going to marry you, Kevin.
What are you talking about?
Well, it's not that I don't love you. That's the trouble, I do. And I don't want to ruin your life.
What's brought this on?
Everything I do. Well, it's all okay for a while, but then it always goes wrong. I tried to change, but I can't.
Don't talk rubbish, Dory.
I've got to say what I feel, Kevin. I've been listening to a lot of people, and I've been doing a lot of thinking on my own. And I know what's right. Sooner or later, I always muck it up.